To La Cuisine with Chef Josette. On a today's show, we are going to have so much fun because I'm going to show you how to prepare the French dish, le coq au vin. Made with a rooster, not with a chicken. Also, I'm going to show you authentic French dessert, chocolate mousse and crêpe Suzette, flambé in a Grand Marnier. But before we do that, I'm going to take you to France, in Normandy, to visit my French distillery, where they make the finest cognac called Le Calvados. So let's see how the Calvados is made in France. We are traveling to France in Normandy to visit one of the oldest distilleries that produce one of the finest forms of brandy called Calvados. The Christian Drouin Distillery is a cottage-like distillery that is totally dedicated to apple cider and Calvados. We spoke with third-generation family member Guillaume Drouin to discuss his family's history of making Calvados.
Chef Josette, thank you for coming to our distillery. I'm very happy to have you here.
Thank you, Guillaume, to have you in my show today. I understand your family want a lot of awards for making Calvados.
The first 20 years my grandfather started distilling, he was not selling any bottles. He was just distilling, aging the Calvados. And then from that time, he wanted to be sure that he was producing a good Calvados. So from time to time, he used to take a sample out of a cask and present it into a local competition. Every time he got a gold medal. So he thought that he was doing well, and this encouraged him to continue. Chef Josette, how about if I take you for a tour of the distillery now?
As Guillaume took me for a tour of the distillery, I told him, as a young child growing up in Normandy, we all knew of the Christian Drouin Distillery because we always use your Calvados for cooking and flambé de crepes. You are the best. Guillaume, tell me more about your Calvados.
Calvados is a very old spirit. We actually have in France three aged spirits: Cognac, Armagnac, and Calvados. And Calvados is the only one which is made with apples. And the oldest tracts we have about the production of Calvados is from the 16th century. This is the first time that a gentleman wrote that he had distilled cider.
Guillaume explained to me that Calvados is made from approximately 30 varieties of apples. The apples are harvested by shaking them off the trees, then carefully picked and pressed into a juice that is fermented into a dry cider. It is then distilled through a two-part process called double distillation. After distillation, the liquid is then aged in oak barrels for 2 years. Resulting in a brandy with nearly 40% alcohol content. The longer the Calvados is aged, the smoother the drink becomes. As we return to the Christian Drouin showroom, I ask Guillaume to explain about the history of the Calvados.
So the history of Calvados is a very long history, more than 4 or 5 centuries of production. And it has come to a very specific and noble product.
Guillaume, thank you very much for your time. You're wonderful. The place is absolutely unbelievable.
It was a great pleasure to have you here. Before you go, would you like to taste some Calvados with me?
Well, I don't say no.
Cheers.
Cheers. Thank you, Guillaume, again. Welcome back to the show. I'm so excited today because we are going to have so much fun. I'm going to show you how to prepare a French dish recipe, le coq au vin. They say that Julius Caesar's chef created the recipe of the coq au vin. However, I think has to be a French chef. Let me show you how we do the coq au vin and you will understand. We're going to start by the chicken. We use the rooster because we have too many roosters in France. We have a lot of chicken farm because we use a lot of eggs. You will see, like today, we're going to do chocolate mousse with egg white. Are you excited, everybody?
Yes.
Very good. So I prepare already cut a rooster and some vegetable. It's so easy. Marinade need red wine, salt, pepper, and seasoning. It's all. You have to get the strongest wine you have in the supermarket. I will use Zinfandel, Cabernet Sauvignon, no Pinot Noir, and no Merlot. It's not enough strong. We need the most flavor. You will understand when I will show you after the 24 hours we marinate. So what we do, we do just 1 spoon for 1 chicken or 1 rooster, 1 tablespoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of pepper, and some herb. Mix oregano, bay leaf, just to do like the seasoning. Voilà. And I add my onion, carrots, and celery. Voilà. It's so simple. And just pour the wine over the chicken. Hope the chicken is not going to be drunk. So 1 liter is enough. Voilà. And what you do, I would like you mix all the spices. That way, all your meat or the chicken will have the seasoning and the red wine. I would like to tell you why I'm dipping the chicken rooster on a red wine. The meat is very, very firm on the rooster. It's for that in France, we create le coq au vin. You're going to make 20, we're going to put 24 hours on a refrigerator, and it's going to be much tender, and we'll cook 2.5 hours. Okay, so let me show you now what I did. Of course, I want to make sure you know all the secrets. So I prepare another dish, the same one of this one. And like that, you can see how the chicken drink. And you can see the different color. So the wine gets into the chicken, the rooster. Today I did a rooster. But like I said, rooster will cook 2.5 hours and the chicken 1 hour. So what I do, I separate the meat. And I'm going to separate the vegetable as well and drain the wine because we're going to make the sauce. Let me, in the meantime, turn on the casserole and I'm going to show you how we have just to sauté and the flavor is coming from the wine. And today I'm going to flambé with Calvados. Do you know what Calvados is? It's the finest cognac made in France. You cannot find Calvados anywhere else except Normandy, France. Voilà. So the butter is going to melt. Because I'm going to do the base to make the sauce. Okay, everybody is hungry? Okay. So you can see I separate the meat and I'm going to drain the wine later. So just between less brown. Oh, did you eat? Mmm, it smells so good. The wine flavor is coming up from the casserole. I usually use all my hands.
So what you do, you have, we say coq au vin sauté. So what we have to do, we have to wait. They are brown, just sauté. So let me between, it's sauté. Let me show you what I do. I just separate the wine and I'm going to do the sauce with it. And I'm going to save the vegetable, what I will add 20 minutes before the end of the cooking. Voilà. And that is going to be my wine. Voilà. Let's see how's our chicken. You see how it looks good? Voilà. And it smells so good. Voilà. And again. And we're going to make the sauce with the last bunch. And we're going to flambé with calvados. Voilà. So you remember to cook the rooster's cooking 2.5 hours and the chicken 1 hour. We do, and actually in my restaurant, I do the chicken too, because like you said, it's not easy to find a rooster. So let me, I'm going to flambé like we do in France. Just split, splash, and be all ready. The finest restaurant in France has always using flambé. So now, the coq au vin is flambé. Let's just finish the sauce. Just 2 spoons of flour. We're making the base. Like one day I make sauce bechamel. You remember last weekend? Let me do that. And just mix together. Voilà. And just pour the wine over. And I'm not going to seasoning yet because you know the marinade has the salt, pepper, and the herb. It's so simple. Voilà. So you have to let loud the sauce to cook. Maybe 3 minutes. And you, as you go, you add the wine. Oh, it smells so good. Okay, and just pour the rest of your chicken already sauté inside the pot. And later on, we're going to put 30 minutes before the end of the cooking. Let me put a little bit right now, just to get the flavor. But if you leave, if I do leave all the vegetables for 2.5 hours, we're going to make a puree. So it's for that I'm just putting a little bit for the taste, for the flavor. And we'll put the rest, cover, and simmer for 2.5 hours. But 30 minutes before, we will have to put the vegetable and the potatoes in. It's very, very excited today because I'm going to show you 2 authentic French desserts. Chocolate mousse and crepe Suzette flambé. So let me start by the chocolate mousse. Like I was telling you, we use a lot of eggs in France. And we use egg white and not cream. So let's start it to put our egg white in the mixer at high speed. And just add a little salt. So we have the chocolate now. We're going to put in a bain-marie. Voilà. I bought a small chip, like that is melting faster. But otherwise, you can always use a piece of chocolate and put them on. Let's do the chocolate. Be careful. You have to lower the heat and make sure the chocolate is melting, not burning, and not cooking. Voilà. Et en the meantime, I'm going to warm the butter. So you have to add to the chocolate one spoon of butter. Voilà. Okay. Voilà. We have three steps. Sugar and egg yolk, egg white, and the chocolate. So let me prepare now the egg yolk. Just add the sugar. Look fast. Voilà. And what you have to do, you have to whip like until your egg yolk and the sugar is come back together and make like a Reuben. You see? Voilà. And I'm going to show you how they look, the chocolate and look the texture, you see? And it's not cooked, it doesn't get to the end of your pan. And it's still to be hot. And I'm going to combine the egg yolk and the sugar. Okay, now it's done. The egg white is firm. Voilà. So I'm going to add just 3 ounces of butter. You can see how the texture is coming up. And add the 8 egg yolks. Voilà. So you can see the texture of the chocolate mousse. Let me show you what we do. So remember, 1 egg yolk, sugar, butter, chocolate. You see that? And we're just going to add the egg white. It's where it's the most difficult. So your chocolate is the right temperature. The egg white is firm. And you cannot use the whip anymore. Otherwise, your chocolate mousse will go down. So let me show you. And did you see I did a little bit? I just want to show you. You see? One day I will do il flottant. So you see?
Ah.
And what you do, you have to add slowly, not everything only one time. And what you do, you just get your spatula and you just stir. It's all, you see? Okay, so you see how you have to combine together and you add it on. It's for over 7 cups, 7 to 8 cups. Voila. So are you excited? Now I'm going to show you how to do a crepe. So please, no whipping. Ingredient is only eggs, chocolate, and butter. But what it is the way you mix together. Okay? Voilà. Okay. Let me do it another way. It looks like a crème brûlée. You see? And it looks no cream. Voilà. At home, you can do whatever you like. So now let's make the crepe. The chocolate mousse is done. Let's show you how to make crepe Suzette flambé with a Grand Marnier. I prepare my crepes 1 hour before. Just put a little butter. Just to warm the crepes. You're going to see so good. Just pour it in. Just heat it up the crepes like that when you have your friends home. The crepes is already made. Just slip over. Whoop. Whoop. Woo. Woo. Okay. And just flambé. 1 touch of Grand Marnier. I love Grand Marnier. You can always do with Calvados. Voilà. And some orange juice. What I prepared earlier. Voilà. Look how she's dancing, the crab is dancing. Voilà. We are going to test whatever we made today. So let's start. We're going to have chocolate mousse, crepe Suzette, maybe for Maggie. Yes, Maggie. Of course, Maggie. Look at that. And it's from orange. Can you test? You have to test, my love. You tell me how you feel, okay? Let me know. And I'm going to have the chocolate mousse for Jocelyn. No cream, only egg white. Voilà. And Chef Juan Carlos prepared for me. He had the potatoes and the vegetable. The coq au vin. You know what is made? The coq au vin is made from?
Rooster.
Good. She's a so beautiful student. Okay, would you mind to test it? Let me know if the sauce is at your taste. Bon appétit. Maggie, did you like it? Do you want I teach you how to make home? I said you can do crepe for your mama. Yes? So, don't forget, you can have the recipe on my website, josettebistro.com. And don't forget, food is my passion. Until next time, à bientôt.